Today, we're going to talk about Gcodes. Apparently, with my videos, I may have caused a little bit of confusion as to why I used them at the end of the video. And my premise for it was to show you how to test the actual functionality of what you're working with. That's why at the end of every video, I try and test to prove that things work. So what I'm going to do today is I'm actually going to talk about Gcodes and help you understand better what is actually occurring. So what I've done is I've opened up the Marlin firmware for Gcodes so that you can see what they're actually used for. So each Gcode corresponds to a command that is interpreted by the printer software that you may use. A lot of people use either Cura, or in my case, being old school, I like to use Pronterface because of the simplicity of the actual environment that you're working in. So I'm going to go to one of the commands over here called G28. And what that is auto home. And what they describe is what you can use and how to use the command. This allows you to actually home all of your axi or axes to their home location next to their corresponding end stops on their axi. So that's one of the commands that normally I don't show you, but there's a whole list of other commands, like M119 is one that I use quite often. And this basically tells you what the state of your end stops are, if they're triggered or not. The reason that I do this is to actually prove the functionality. So now that I've gone through that, I'm actually going to show you how it works with actually printing. Now, I'm going to have to take you through a couple of steps. So I'm going to show you with the use of a calibration cube from Thingiverse. Now, normally you would download this to your computer, which I've already done, and then extract it. And I'll show you what the actual folder looks like for the actual files. So this is an extracted folder, and what they do is they show you the images that are in the folder, and they also show you the files. Now I have extensions not hidden on my computer so that you can see that it says STL. That means stereolithography file. So it's basically a model of what you want to print. So what you need to do with this is actually go to a program, for instance, like Slic3r, which is included in a lot of 3D printer softwares now, like Cura. And I'll show you actually what happens on the model. So I'm going to click on Add, and I'm just going to pick one of these models and open it. And as you can see, it shows you what the model looks like. And in here, in Slic3r, it allows you to rescale, rotate, other things like that. I'm actually not going to cover that. I'm just going to show you what happens when you actually slice it. But I want to show you something about printer settings. Over here, they go into a couple of printer settings for your printer. Now, obviously, I don't have this set up for a printer on this computer, but it shows you your nozzle diameter. And then, of course, there are different things about your printer that it will show you on various tabs, like the layer height. But some of the important things that you'll see at the beginning of your start Gcode is something like G28, which is home all the axi. So the actual semicolon, anything that's after it, is actually a comment to show you what's happening. And then there's another comment over here for lift nozzle. But basically, this is movement of your printer that's defined by Gcodes. So now that we know that, and we know that there might be an end state where like temperatures are turned off and things like that, we have a little bit of information as to what's occurring. So I'm going to go back over and I'm actually going to export this as a Gcode. So I'm going to click here. I'm going to keep the defaults and I'm going to save it. So before I actually show you what's occurring in Pronterface when you load this, I'm going to show you what the file looks like. So I'm going to go to the folder, and as you can see, here's the file. So I'm going to actually open this in Notepad++. And as you can see, right here, the initial thing that occurs is that it homes all the axi after it's turning on the temperature and things like that. So you can see a list of commands down here where there's actually movements occurring. This is the actual commands that you're sending to the printer. So it's going line by line in order to print your file. Now this file, in terms of if you were to look at it from the lens of computer science, is known as an interpreted file. So each command is executed as it's read, whereas a compiled file will compile things down into other languages that the computer can understand. In this case, it's just reading commands and processing them. So when you compile a binary file, it would actually be binary commands, which is ones and zeros. In this case, it's actual commands that it's comparing to its logic of the actual software on your printer to execute these commands. So now that we know a little bit about the Gcodes, let's double check to see what happens at the bottom. So there's a bunch of comments down here, but at the end, it turns off the actual printer temperature. So that's how it corresponds to the Slic3r software. So it's creating layer by layer prints that are executed with G commands or Gcodes, pardon me. So if we were to actually go to Pronterface, as you can see right here, we can actually load that file by clicking on, obviously, load file. And we can actually click on the Gcode, which is the file that we were just looking at, and open that. So what we see here is a little bit of information about the file, the dimensions, and where it's going to print possibly. There's a lot of little commands that I'm not going to cover in this that you can look up on your own for Gcodes. But let's look what happens. So if we click here and expand this window out, right now it appears to be blank, meaning that we're seeing nothing. And then down here you see what looks like a taskbar. That is actually not it. It's actually over on the right hand side. So these are actually the layers. They're graded out for the scaling. So each one of these is probably a layer. So let's go up to the first one. And as you can see, it's drawing what it thinks it should be per your Gcode. So it's an interpretation of what the commands are for that layer. So if you go up layer by layer, you can see there's a solid layer there with a hole in it. And then if you go up another layer, you can see that there's another layer on top of that, and so on and so forth. Now you'll start to see something like a honeycomb. This is actually the spacing that they use so that you can conserve actual filament, because it's a non-solid for the settings inside the center. So it's printing something similar to a honeycomb to conserve on filament when you print. And so that's going to go on for a bit, and there might be layers that are filled in, but it's showing layer by layer what the print will actually look like. So when it gets to the top, it'll actually start to print the actual lettering that's defined by the Gcodes. So this is a great way to verify your work, and also if you have problems with your Gcodes, because sometimes when you think something is occurring in one of the slicing programs, it might not slice correctly. So you always have a way to refer back and test the commands by copying these out and actually putting or placing them inside your actual printer software, such as Pronterface. So that's why I always emphasize Pronterface for the commands over here. This allows us to actually check to see that these commands are correct, as you would see on the printer when it's actually connected. So for home wall accesses, if you were to copy out that command and paste it right here, in theory, when you do G28, you would see that your printer actually homes for X, Y, and Z. So I want to take a moment to thank all my users for suggesting this video. And please like and subscribe. And if you don't already, send tips in my direction with PayPal. For those that do, thank you very much. It's of great help to offset my costs for the actual production of these tutorials. And have a nice day and take care.